represent Physiques of Greatness. And you see the title of the video, Homies and Homettes. Wanted to touch on this topic, man. I'm not sure if a lot of you guys follow bodybuilding forums or little underground websites, but this is real big in bodybuilding forums. It's a big topic. I decided I wanted to touch on it a little bit for my own personal reasons. I'm going to post fucking pictures on the screen so you can get an idea of what I'm talking about. But long story short, I'm actually looking at a website right now, so excuse me. See? So I'm going to be looking down quite a bit. I don't want no hippie motherfucker talking about, oh, you should be looking into the camera. Shut the fuck up. I be reading the comments. I may not respond to everybody, but I read them. So anyway. So, I'm not sure if anybody y'all follow bodybuilding, but in 1993, a woman by the name of Denise Rutkowski, I'm not sure if I pronounced that right, but hopefully I did. Denise Rutkowski, she placed second place in Miss Olympia. Okay, now here it goes. I'm gonna post pictures on the screen. Now, as you see this picture right here, she was on the roids. However, she didn't look bad. I mean, she wasn't crazy muscular. You know, she just real thick looking. She's obviously practicing her posing right here. Big thighs, big ass, long hair, don't care. You know, she's looking alright. I'll probably hit that, you know. Even though she's on steroids, I ain't gonna lie, I'll probably hit that, you know. I'm gonna keep it real, shit. Now, look at this picture. Obviously taken post-competition. She's obviously like damn near, this was show ready conditioning back then. You know, of course, from the 1970s, 80s, 90s, and until now, conditioning standards have changed. Arnold Schwarzenegger and his prime contest conditioning wouldn't even place in today's Olympia standards. So yes, this is a show ready conditioning right here. And as you see, no sir, I will not be hitting that. Very muscular. Very hard looking. She's bigger than me. Probably not on the scale, but definitely look wise. She's 3D than a motherfucker. Here's another picture of her doing a tricep shot. Look at her face. Alright, great smile, but you can see she got like the square jaw look. Another side effect of steroids. You know what I'm saying? They start getting their manly features. You know, testosterone is a male hormone. When you inject that into a female, they start just transforming slowly but surely if they're taking high professional bodybuilding dosages. Just look at Iris Kyle. No disrespect to Iris Kyle, but she's not very feminine. She's very manly looking. Okay, no disrespect, but we keep it real up in this bitch. Now, this is how she looks now. God damn! Now, obviously, this is a mugshot. You know, so you can't just talk shit because, you know, who's ever been arrested, you know, and they photo shoot ready? Only a handful of people have ever been arrested and they're like photo shoot ready. You know, I remember when I got arrested for tickets, I was on my way home from the gym and I got pulled over for like a taillight being out, and I went to jail for some tickets. And, you know, of course, they take pictures of you, and I wasn't looking my best either. You know what I mean? So, you know, I'm gonna give her a pass. But as you can see, she looks sucked up, dried up, and she got a motherfucking goatee. Now, a lot of people are saying a lot of this has to do with the side effects of steroids, you know, coming off the gear, and you're fucking up your hormones, and that's very, very true, man. When you take steroids for several years and shit, and you get off, you could fuck up your hormones, especially if you're a woman. And obviously she did. Look at it. She's all sucked up and dried up, neck all skinny, skin all bad. Now, this is not just a side effect of steroids. Obviously, she's doing much more than, this has to do much more with just coming out of steroids. She's obviously on drugs, too. I've seen this a lot in my old community. You know, a lot of people look like this when they're living in the streets, man. She's obviously on some crack, heroin, or something else. There's other things going on with this lady. But far the less, she got a motherfucking goatee, okay? Looks terrible. But the point I'm trying to make is here, you know, it really kills me, and y'all know who I'm talking about, a lot of these bodybuilders running around saying, oh, it's not steroids, it's hard work. I'm not denying that these guys work their ass off, but let's be real here. That's a motherfucking woman, okay? A woman. When women work out, I don't give a damn how hard you train. I don't give a damn how hard you train, how hard you bulk. None of that shit. You can only get so big as a woman. Point blank fucking period. I don't give a damn how hard you train. Women train, they don't look like these fucking female bodybuilders you see at the Olympia. They don't even look like a lot of these fitness models that we're looking at on Instagram. You get sexy, fit, toned, lean. You don't look like this shit. You don't have the testosterone to build like this. So if a woman can inject testosterone in her body and get bigger and much more impressive than me and you, then just imagine how big a man could get off this shit. If this is what a woman can do, keep in mind there's no way in fucking hell she can even get close to that size naturally. If she could look like that just by taking steroids, then damn, of course, if a man takes it, sky is the limit. Sky's the fucking limit. If it could transform a woman into that, it pretty much just gave her muscles. So, no, it is not all hard work, motherfucker. It is fucking steroids, too. When you get your fucking trophy at that fucking show, you need to thank your fucking coach. You need to thank your parents for those genetics. And thank whoever sold you them good drugs. Shit. Fucking kills me how these motherfuckers be in denial. You know so many people got mental problems. No disrespect. But a lot of these bodybuilders aren't all the way there. You know, these motherfuckers be taking advantage of y'all, man. A lot of these guys be taking steroids. They be taking small dosages just so they can take pictures and shit. And how you thinking? Well, I'm not even gonna get into all that shit. This video will be 20 minutes ranting about these motherfucking con artists out here. But point I'm trying to make, man, it's not all fucking hard work, goddammit. You see what steroids can do? Shit. It turned this goddamn woman into a man. It will turn a man into a beast. You know what I'm saying? But hey, man, if anybody out there thinking about taking steroids, I'm not going to try to talk you out of it, because at the end of the day, we got to live our own fucking life. But just be sure you know what the fuck you're doing. And be sure you have some good health insurance with it, because if that shit fucks you up, at least you can go to a doctor and get taken care of. A lot of people don't have health insurance. Honestly, I didn't get health insurance until a year ago. The struggle is fucking real, man. I got some clients in fucking Canada, and he was telling me how he caught a hernia and all this other shit. And I was like, damn, man, how much this shit cost you to get fixed? This nigga told me that he went to the hospital and they just fixed them up for free. In America, that's unheard of. You know, I caught a hernia when I was about 20. And I didn't even get it fixed till I was about 22 because I didn't have insurance. You know what I mean? What I did was I got insurance and then I waited about 5 months or so. Then I went and got it fixed. Ain't that a bitch? You know, America's fucked up when it comes to healthcare, man. So make sure you got some health insurance, especially if you live in the States. And, you know, do what the fuck you want. But honestly, me, I have no financial gain to make from taking steroids. You know, taking steroids is not going to make me any more money than I'm already making. It's not going to make me any more popular. And quite frankly, man, as long as you got muscles in your fit, women will hop on your dick. You ain't got to be walking around looking like fucking Kai Green and Fear Heath to get no hoes. Trust me. You know what I'm saying? I walk around my 195-pound body with that top down, women admiring. Guns hugging the sleeves. You ain't got to be the biggest guy in the gym. Women don't even like all that. Well, most women don't even like all that. We just got to be in shape. Just get in shape. All you got to do is get in shape. You know what I'm saying? Enjoy your life, man. No point of, you know, the point of being into the bodybuilding lifestyle is to be healthy and fit. That's not being healthy and fit. Injecting a whole bunch of drugs into your body, enlarging your heart, you know, probably shorten your lifespan. It's not fucking worth it. But anyway, just wanted to share it with y'all, man. You bodybuilders out there, you know what fucking steroids. You know what fucking steroids can do. It ain't fucking all hard work, goddammit. Don't forget to like my shit. Comment, subscribe. Holla back at your boy.